Hey everybody, I'm Jim.
I'm Rich.
We're playing Resident Rise.
And Jim's a pincushion.
Oh yeah, I am a super pincushion. I just got in a fight with a Minotaurus. We just wrapped up a Blood Moon. It was not pretty.
It was bloody.
Yep. Charge my jetpack, because I have to go into the Nether today and establish Power Station Beta.
And I'm going to wander out here and put one of these nodes into a jar.
We also need to deal with the tree farm if we have time. The tree farm is great. It is now self-sustaining. We moved the harvester. We put up a little safety fence because safety fencing is important so your penguin friends don't die.
Teach your penguins not to try and bathe in boiling water. Really, who takes a bath in boiling water, honestly?
Anyway, well, we need to fence it off because we've got monsters spawning in the upper branches. So we're going to do some design work on that. But in the meantime, I'm going to go to the Nether and abandon Rick with the deadly tree farm.
Yay! Remember, safety. You're going to the Nether without your fire protection.
That is true. I'm not going to go fight any blazes, that's for damn sure.
Are you sure?
100%.
We're going to have to kidnap that blaze spawner one of these days. Or we could, you know, using Mine Factory Reloaded auto spawner.
Well, you can kidnap the blaze spawner.
Alright,
so Power Station Alpha is looking pretty good. And we've got Enrique with us to help us build Power Station Beta.
You sure it's Enrique?
Yes.
Okay, because you were having trouble with names earlier.
Well, I just hadn't used Enrique the entire time we were filming.
He's feeling unloved.
That's why we're going to put him to work. Get some purpose.
Okay.
Alright, this is the one that's like right at the base of that Nether Fortress.
I don't know.
I do. I'm standing there.
Okay. So what I am doing is getting ready to put this node into a jar. First, I got to build the gigantic jar around it. I don't use my friends to build jars for me.
Now we're gonna build a platform. We do not want to just calculate the cost. We do want him to return to the start. You know what I didn't bring?
Enrique?
Any kind of wood.
Why would you want wood in the Nether?
Trapdoor. For the...
Yeah.
For the roof?
Well, anyways, that node is inside that, and right click. Boom! I now have a node in a jar.
I think I just... drowned a hellhound?
How? You don't have water.
Yeah, I know. It's just sort of laying in the lava, being sad. Like, it's not, it doesn't seem particularly put out by being in the lava. Ooh, infernal hive. So now we're using hardened glass, which is reinforced and should have the strength of obsidian. So, unlike Power Station Alpha, if Power Station Beta takes a stray shot from a ghast, we're going to be okay.
Okay, well, he's working on that. Node, a jar. Got it out, brought it back to base. Now how do I release it? Oh, there we go. And now, something I'm going to be doing, dragging a whole bunch of nodes back with me, but I will do that off camera because that's going to be a lot of work.
We really need you to build some kind of magical safety cage.
I don't think I have anything that'll hurt people in my magic room anymore.
Uh-huh. I don't like the uncertainty in your voice when you say that.
Well, I don't think... Well, they can't climb into my cauldron anymore, or my crucible. And walking into it doesn't hurt anybody.
Uh-huh.
My alchemical furnace doesn't hurt people, neither does the alembic. Really, I'd be more worried about the golems going on strike and rioting or something. They can't do that, as far as I know.
Hmm, that seems good.
But now, I'm going to make some flowers. Because... I need to be able to generate mana again, because all my
lovely...
That's
cool. I don't have enough hardened glass for this.
You should have thought of that.
Yep.
So I am going to make an endoflame. I'm going to need a bunch of these.
What is that? You know what? I don't want to know.
I need mana powder, apparently. What is mana powder?
What is mana powder?
Oh, I apparently have to drop sugar or white powder or orange berries powders or dust into a mana pool to get... mana powder. We got any sugar? I don't really want to use, some of the other stuff for it. Sugar cane turns into sugar, right?
Yep, that is how sugar cane works. Both in Minecraft and in real life. The more you know... What the hell?
I didn't do it.
Oh god, oh, it's a magma cube.
That doesn't sound that bad.
I just saw this shape lurking beneath the lava. Moving up and down, and I couldn't tell what it was, because I only saw it out of the corner of my eye. It's a magma cube. Everything's fine.
So now I'm going to need mystical brown, mystical red, mystical light gray.
But I haven't seen any. Here's some. That dense cobalt, though.
Oh, man.
There we go. Look at that.
Gray, brown, and red.
While we're doing that, we're going to put our endothermic pump in here. We also brought an ender tank. We're just going to leave off the side for now. Enrique is out of gas. Well, he is out of glass, to be precise.
Now I'd go do some more magic mojo. Boom. Boom. Boop. I forgot the seeds.
What seeds?
Any seeds.
What?
I need seeds for magic.
Oh, weird.
Well, flower magic.
I don't know what that is, but I don't want to fuck with it.
What did it look like?
A person.
And I have now made an endoflame.
Ow. Double ow. Triple ow. Ah, suck it, gas.
Wow, I did not realize this. You can right-click with an empty hand app, put back the ingredients for the last recipe you used.
Oh, neat.
I wonder when they added that in. So, I'm going to need a few of these. Let's get some more mystical flowers. Or petals, rather.
Are you in mining world or in regular world?
I'm in regular world.
Oh, okay.
Yes, I already got myself a node.
I realized, I just had a thought about what would definitely fix tree farm.
What's that?
Put in another harvester.
Yeah?
It's not a bad idea.
You would need another,
No, I could use the same sludge boiler.
I think you might overpower it.
Maybe. Yeah, we are definitely going to need some more... pulverized obsidian. And we're going to need some more... lead. Let's see if we can't go at least finish that job.
I really need to get a golem to fill this thing in for me. That's one of the other things I'm going to be doing after this episode, is making various golems.
You gotta name them, man.
You really want me naming things?
That's the one of the differences between friends and slaves. Given that we've established a strict no-slavery policy...
Yeah, but minions are okay.
That's unclear, actually.
Why? What's unclear about minions?
I don't know that we established that minions are okay.
You never said they weren't before, so...
That doesn't make them automatically okay.
Yeah, time limit's passed.
What? No.
Yep.
No.
Yeah, that's how it works.
Rick?
Yeah?
Do I have to get the crossbow? Crossbow lesson.
Would it stop you either way? You enjoy that way too much.
Wait until I build an ender rifle.
Man, wait till I find a way to send bats after you. Hell bats especially. I'll send fire bats at you.
Those fire bats are the worst. Alright, Enrique, let's see if being me going to the other world wiped your program. It doesn't look like it did. Excellent.
How do we not have a pressure plate yet?
For what?
I need a pressure plate.
Oh, yeah, no, I only build them as I need them.
I also need a way to run the... a spot to run an ME cable.
I love that there are nether trees. It looks super cool.
Well, I guess Jim's not really using this ME cable I conveniently placed for him.
Oh, I don't know what those are, but they look unfriendly.
Are you sure they're unfriendly?
They just all looked at me and started moving toward me. That, in Minecraft, is a deep sign that something wants to hurt you.
I don't know. You could be wrong about this, man.
Enrique, I gave you 50 blocks.
Use them all already?
Apparently. Oh, Enrique, no!
No, Enrique. What have you done?
I did not...
Did you just lose another friend?
Build a cushion for Enrique when I took him apart. And Enrique had an accident.
Yeah, you see, he blames me for these things.
You see, one was all me. You know how I can tell? You're nowhere around, and it was my stuff.
Yeah, we see how he treats his friends now.
That was
he jumps them in lava.
Workplace accident, and now I have to go build a tombstone for Enrique.
He blames me.
I blame you when it's your fault!
Uh-huh. Just a convenient scapegoat for him.
What do you mean, convenient scapegoat? You're the most inconvenient of scapegoats.
Why am I the most inconvenient? What makes me the most inconvenient?
Because you keep complaining about it. Not to mention that, generally speaking, you want your scapegoat to be someone who is not actually evil.
Me? Listen, I have not been doing evil things yet.
Sorry, I couldn't hear you after you burst into flame on contact with sunlight, kept going crazy with dark magic, and now are talking about how minions are totally different from slaves.
Well, yeah. Have you seen Despicable Me? Were they slaves?
Yes!
Oh, okay. I haven't seen Despicable Me, so I don't know.
Oh.
I'm very bad when it comes to actually seeing movies.
Enrique. So, I need to see how to make gravestones, which are part of DecoCraft, so you can't view them. But for now...
Oh, you go to this deco bench I have over here?
Mm-hmm.
And you could put in a search. Is it called gravestone?
Yeah.
So you'll need 3 clay, 1 red, 1 green, and 1 blue.
What do you mean, one red, one green, one blue?
Okay, so what there is... Actually, it looks like I've got 11 red, 3 green, 3 blue colors in there already.
So I just need 3 clay?
No, it's already got some clay stored in it, I think. 9 clay.
So
what you do is you mix clay with dye and then put it into the table. It'll store it all. And then you can just make it. That's another thing I'm going to have to set up. So, what did I do wrong to make the open grate? Oh, living wood planks. I think I was trying to use straight living wood.
Now, can I engrave the gravestone?
I don't know. Put a sign there.
Yeah, that's my plan. I need to learn more about this echo craft table, quite clearly.
Well, you're generally too busy giving me shit.
Oh, no, actually, we do want it like that.
Let's use the hopper. Right, dirt. We need dirt. And I'm going to need redstone stuff eventually, but let's place this. Because I'm bad with redstone stuff. Okay, so... Let's see here.
There we go. Not quite parallel with the grave marker.
Place the open grate there. I don't think I'm giving myself enough room here.
Alright. I'll make some more pulverized obsidian.
You can go there. You shall put the hopper there. need redstone to come up.
I'm gonna go get Franklin.
To the hopper. I need a pressure plate.
And we're gonna finish Power Station Beta.
Are you gonna make a platform?
In Enrique's honor.
Are you gonna make a cushion this time?
Of course I'm gonna make a cushion. He wasn't in the right spot.
Terrible things Jim does.
It was a workplace accident, okay? I don't want to talk about it. I'm not saying it wasn't unfortunate, because it was. But...
what's the pressure plate recipe?
Two planks?
Oh, yeah.
Side by side?
Yep. Pressure plate there. How good are you with redstone, Jim?
Oh, pretty good. Why?
Because I'm now trying to figure out how to run a redstone signal up to my hopper properly.
An interesting engineering challenge. What's the goal here?
The goal is to send a redstone signal to the hopper to prevent it from sending stuff through the open crate.
Okay. So, you will probably... sorry, let me just get Franklin set up here.
Oh, I got it. So the idea for this is, the redstone goes from... I might be able to put this redstone in more efficiently, too, if I think about this a bit. But anyways, there's an item been added through Botania called an open crate. And what this does is anything that gets pumped through the crate immediately drops through it. So I have a hopper hooked up to it to pump charcoal through. Follow me so far?
Yep.
Okay. Now, when a hopper gets a redstone signal, it stops sending things through the hopper.
Mm-hmm.
So what I did is I put a pressure plate under the open crate, ran some redstone up to the hopper so that when there's a charcoal on the pressure plate, it won't send any more charcoal through.
Okay.
Now, endoflames will pick up charcoal dropped on the ground to burn for mana.
Okay.
So, but you don't want charcoal piling up in large amounts. So what I do is I place down the pressure plate to stop things going through. An endoflame picks up the charcoal to burn, mm-hmm. and another charcoal drops down for another endoflame to pick up.
Clever. I like that.
Now, here's where the next step comes in, is once I start sending this mana, I need to use a redstone comparator to send a redstone signal to the hopper when the mana pool is full, so that I'm not wasting charcoal that's not going to get picked up by the endoflames.
Mm-hmm.
So... what's going to make it interesting is I believe one of the Thaumcraft mods adds in redstone crystals and a redstone crystal comparator, which can be linked to each other so that it doesn't have to use wires between the two of them. It'll send a wireless signal, essentially. So I'll be able to add that, and I've also...
Creep, gassed.
Okay. How ghastly.
Got it. Sorry, go on. You were saying.
I was just saying I'm going to be using a comparator to turn off the hopper when the stuff's full. And I'm also to put to properly run charcoal into this, I'm going to use an export bus, which I'm going to have to make, I believe. I don't think I have any left. No, I didn't think so. So I'm going down to make an export bus now to export charcoal into the hopper.
Okay, neat.
Right from the ME system. No, what am I missing? Formation core. What do I need to make a formation core? Of course, I don't have what I need. The logic? Yes. Here, let's just make 10 of these while I'm at it. I can demonstrate the crafting CPU. So I have just set it up to craft 10 logic processors for me. And it's already, it'll choose crafting CPU automatically, which is I only have the one. It'll use 90 bytes of the processor of the storage, 1024. Start it up, and we can run down here, and everything down here should be automatically running. You can see it's pressing those, it sends them up here, and presses the logic circuits, importing and exporting everything on its own.
All right, Power Station Beta is now a building.
Okay, we have another Blood Moon, by the way.
Awesome. I am coming home. Power Station Beta, I believe, will be renamed to Power Station Enrique. Okay. How is your Blood Moon going?
Oh, it's going fine.
I look forward to whatever's on the other side of this portal.
Oh, I have no idea what could be over there. Because I'm not over there. I've got the cable run. Now... Oh, I used the wrong bus, right. I didn't want the export bus. There's a better choice.
This looks unimpressive.
Damn it, I turned... Damn it, even though I pulled that off. Need to pop a cable here.
We'll make sure to figure it out next episode.
Well, it's mostly working.